Whisper is a new, easy-to-use, and incredibly powerful multitask speech recognition model. With the same underlying model, Whisper can transcribe speech from a variety of languages into text and even translate speech from other languages into English. OpenAI just released this model to the public. In this video, I'll show you how you can use it on your own devices and data. To install Whisper, you'll need a few dependencies. Namely, you'll need Python, Rust, and FFmpeg. After, you can install Whisper via pip by doing pip install and then the path to the Git repository. Now that we've installed Whisper, we can use it from either Python or the command line. We'll show examples of both, but let's begin with the Python API. First, we import the Whisper module. Then, we load our desired model. When choosing a model, there are two things to consider. First, a model can be either tiny, base, small, medium, or large. Generally, as you work your way from tiny to large, models will include more parameters, take up more space, and take more time to run. Second, models are either multilingual or English specific. So, if you know your audio is English only, you should choose a .n model. As a first task, I want to see how well Whisper can transcribe me. I speak English, so I'll choose an English only model. Let's try the base.n model first. After loading the model, we can use the transcribe method to transcribe audio from a file. Since our model is English only, it doesn't support inferring the language used in the clip. So, we need to manually set the language as N for English. If we were using a multi-language model, Whisper could infer the language automatically. Finally, since I'm running this model on CPU only, I'll set FP16 to false to avoid a mildly annoying warning message. And in about 2 minutes on my MacBook Pro, we're done. Our audio file has been transcribed. In our result object, we can access either the text, which is all the text transcribed from the audio clip in a single string, segments, which are broken up portions of transcribed text with additional metadata, such as timestamps, or language, which is a two-letter code indicating which language was detected. This is all shockingly simple, and it works really well. Let's see how the base.n model compares to the medium.n model. Most importantly, we'll need to generate parameters to pass to our range object. We want tuples contain either 1, 2, or 3 integers, where the third integer is non-zero if provided. In addition, since range's get item supports slicing, we'll want to generate arbitrary slices. Although Hypothesis has a built-in slice strategy, it cannot generate none values for start, stop, or step. Since my last video was 18 minutes long, I've only shown you a short clip. You might think that I've cherry-picked a good example, and you'd be partially right. I chose one of the few segments of the video where the base.n model made any mistakes, and they were pretty minor at that. So, this is whatever the opposite of cherry-picking is. For almost everywhere else, the base model performed shockingly well and was almost identical to the essentially perfect medium.n model. In fact, Whisper performed so well that I think I'll use it to generate subtitles for my videos in the future. Here's an example of what YouTube's automatically generated subtitles produce. There's no capitalization or punctuation, and it generally fails to make a good guess at domain-specific words. By comparison, the Whisper-generated subtitles look like I wrote them by hand. Let's try a non-English clip. Suppose we want to translate the opening scene of the Netflix show Dark, which is natively voiced in German. Let's use the command line interface. Here, we use the Whisper command and specify a path to our file. We set the task to translate because we want to translate the transcribed text from German to English. If instead we want to leave the transcribed text in German, we can leave the task blank or set it to transcribe. Finally, we set our model to large, and we set the FP16 flag to false. And wow, this is almost dead on. Let's compare it side by side with Netflix's original subtitles.
Wir vertrauen darauf, dass die Zeit linear verläuft. Dass sie auf ewig gleichförmig voranschreitet bis in die Unendlichkeit. Aber die Unterscheidung von Vergangenheit, Gegenwart und Zukunft ist nichts als eine Illusion. Gestern, heute, morgen, folgen nicht aufeinander. Sie sind in einem ewigen Kreis miteinander verbunden. Alles ist miteinander verbunden.
So yeah, pretty much perfect. I did try a third example that was less so. Take a look, and after, I'll speculate where I think things are going wrong.
Ashimofu Soren-san, koitsu ga tsugi no shogin-kubi da. Jet-san ya asteroid ittai o shikiru soshiki no kanbu nan da ga na. Shinja orosu tsutta ya na. Ashimofu Soren-san da yo. Nani kiiten da? Niku no nai shinja orosu nante na. Shinja orosu to wa iwanen ja ne no ka na. Iya, iu ne.
Iwaneyo.
Kane ga nai toki wa iu n da yo.
Konaida no shokin 100万 ウーロはどこ行ったんだよ。
お前が壊した機体の修理と、お前が壊した店の修理と、お前が怪我させた警官の治療費でパーだ。3日前、こいつの組織と敵対する組織との抗争があったんだが、こいつは仲間を殺してとんずらしやがった。奴はティワナの女のところに逃げ込んだらしい。
あんなとこ雑魚の行くとこだよ。
雑魚の割に賞金は250万だ。
ならねえな。
ティワナか、あそこの牛はうまいわな。
Ultimately, I think there are at least three things at play. First, Whisper's performance will vary depending on the input language. Granted, Japanese should perform relatively well according to OpenAI's published metrics. Second, I think the fact that there are two characters talking past one another made it difficult for Whisper to draw on context to predict the next words. In the beginning, one character was focused on their next job, and the other was complaining that the special beef and bell peppers didn't contain any beef. In later parts of the conversation, where they were actually talking to one another, Whisper does a reasonable job writing an interpretable transcript. I wonder if the early part of the clip would have been transcribed better if each character was transcribed separately. Finally, I think that the presence of made-up words has the potential to confuse the model. That said, in earlier experiments, I was shocked that Whisper could make reasonable transcriptions of made-up or at least very domain-specific words. In any case, Whisper is awesome. I think its release marks the start of a whole slew of automatic speech recognition-powered applications. I can't wait to see what you build with it.